I'm in.
Hey, and we started a level that isn't, that doesn't make me hate myself.
Okay, so yeah, I got a... I see, okay, okay.
Yep.
A sniper, so I got a long range and a close range thing. I assume
it's
the...
So if you want to go sniper, collecting a bunch of those crowbars can get real goofy, because after a certain point you just start one-shotting everything. I'm going to hit the Shrine of the Mountain.
I remember one of the things that got me a lot of vaccine last time was something to do with this other gun that's not the sniper. Is there like some shotgun blast that when you let go, is that something to do with it?
Yeah, I honestly, I don't know.
Okay. Oh no, it's gonna happen again.
Multi is absolutely like the character that I use the least out of all of them. For no unspecific reason, I just kind of don't use him much.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, okay, and I can run into enemies, just literally run into them with my dash. That's pretty neat. Stunning canister. Deal damage to enemies, dash. Oh, gain 200 armor. Ooh. I see. Seems relatively slow. It seems like maybe the drawback, if I were to guess.
Yeah, Multi is the slowest character.
Okay.
Bye. But speed is one of the few things that you can really get a lot of items early on to just get around it.
Yeah.
If you see something that looks like soda, like a soda can,
okay,
that increases your sprint speed considerably, which is super nice. I mean, for anybody, but especially for Multi.
Yeah. Well, if you see one, just for my quality of life, I would not mind getting one.
Because
boy, he is slow.
After this run, maybe we could try command mode so you can actually play around with going for a specific build.
That could be interesting, yeah. Summon the Lemurians to fight. These fire boys are the Lemurmen. Oh my god.
Yep, and they hurt.
So this, I'm assuming you're one of the melee characters. It seems to be
yep,
the case. He's a fragile melee character too. Wow.
He's normally not that fragile. But I don't have any items yet. Oh.
Oh my god.
I don't know where all those stone boys came from, but
I don't know.
I'm failing.
I don't like them.
I'll be back.
Okay.
So one of the main benefits of drizzle mode is we get heightened, just natural regen to get our HP back.
Okay. Oh my god. Yeah, I can't. I just, this move speed. I couldn't do a whole run without getting any speed upgrades. Holy moly. It's pretty jarringly slow.
Let's see. I'll be back in a bit. I just needed to get my HP back. Everything down there got bad.
Yeah, it got spicy.
Oh, that's really good.
What do you got down there?
Use item, heal for a percentage of the damage ideal for 8 seconds.
Oh.
Not like the best use item ever, but pretty nice.
Sounds kind of fun. Goat hoof, move faster.
Yep.
Oh my god.
That was the other item that I was going to recommend you get. That, and I guess the last one would be Red Whip, which you found earlier. That was the one that makes it so you run faster out of combat. Ooh. Okay. Let's see. Did you manage to deal with that fresh hell that I left behind?
Yeah. Absolutely. I'm very good at video games.
Well, I mean,
I am
you
sometimes.
Didn't die, and I almost did. So.
I mean, I almost did too. Oh, sprint faster!
Yeah,
watch out,
drink.
World! Watch out! I can move. I can fight. Wow. Oh my god, you look like you're having fun up there.
I've never really used this character, and I'm liking him. You know how you were saying you could blink upwards with the Huntress?
Yeah.
Well, this character can do like an attack dash upwards as well.
Ooh. Yeah, I did like that feeling.
I should not. So there's an item on the ground that you might see that is blue. It's called Glowing Meteorite.
Okay.
It makes it so meteors will fall on the entire stage.
Okay. Is that it down?
It can hit us.
Is that it down there? Is that why you mentioned
it? Yeah.
Why would you want it? Because it can hit enemies too? Or something?
Yeah,
or?
It hits enemies too. It's better against enemies because, you know, many of them, larger targets generally.
Yeah.
Same time, real risky. And
yeah.
Apparently got buffed too. That's real good. That's what I want to hear. Where the heck is the teleporter? Oh, I know where it is. I'm gonna go trigger it because I don't think there's any items left.
All right. Wow, we both have three. Yeah, I don't see anymore. Download environmental data? What is that?
I totally forget.
208 bucks, it's on the ground. Download data.
Ooh, okay.
Double boy?
Yep.
Oh no.
Yeah, I'm liking Mercenary a little bit more than I did in the past. He used to be more awkward, and maybe a lot of it just has to do with the fact that now I understand how he works.
I mean, he seems like he's really mobile, which seems like a very fun thing to be able to have in this game.
Yep.
Maybe I'm just saying that because of being the way I am right now, but it seems like a thing that, like, the double jumps seem like they change a lot, and it seems like, does your character have, like, a built-in double jump effectively? Kind
of? Yeah, so I start with double jump, and I can use my sprint, or it's not my sprint, it's, like, the dash move. I can do that into the sky. Ooh, Knurl! Yes! Okay, so grab one of each. You're gonna like the Titanic Knurl.
I bet so. Ooh, yeah. Yep. That's my brand right now. Non-dying. That's my plan.
I used to play Risk of Rain 1 a lot, and there was a series of settings that I could do that more or less guaranteed that I got like 5 of those on the first level, give or take. It was a very quick way of just absolutely destroying this game. Hey, blue portal. That's useful.
Blue portal? What is that? Was that?
Yeah. This might. We'll see how this goes.
Okay. I'm scared.
Okay. So, I usually play this with fans who know more about this game than I do. So now that I actually have to rely on my own knowledge, I'm like, oh yeah, I got caps. So a couple things. So over here are the lunar coin items. I was telling you about them. They're the ones with the drawbacks. I wouldn't recommend grabbing any of them unless you know what they do.
Okay.
The other thing is you can come over here, and you can actually trade in items to get another item. So if you want to trade in items to get the double jump, you could. Or, I don't know what this does. I wouldn't actually recommend it right now.
Okay.
But, options?
Then what the heck is...
Let's see.
Dream.
I think this lets us choose which level we go to next.
Okay. And this guy has a health bar. I know because I shot him. I feel like I probably shouldn't have. Gesture of the...
Ooh, that's really good. So Gesture of the Drown drastically reduces the cooldown of all of my activated items, but it's... It automatically activates.
Oh.
So now my
use item
activates.
That's great.
Yeah. Yeah, so it now activates every 30 seconds, gives me 8 seconds of HP regen. So I can't exactly use it situationally, but it's still good.
It seems nice.
I want to say... let's see, chat. If we want to get to the place to unlock... What's his face? We go down, right? Oh, can you see the... Artificer next to the newt.
The artificer.
Zippy.
Yeah. I assume the artificer is this thing that's trapped for 10 coins that I only have 6 of.
What if I do this? Does this work for you?
I don't know. I didn't get a pop-up or anything.
Well, I didn't either.
I mean, I couldn't have done anything anyways. I didn't have enough.
Okay, so do you wanna go do something? If we got Knurls, we might be okay with this.
I'll do whatever. I don't know what I'm doing.
All right. So we're actually going to jump. Now you don't take falling damage, so you don't have to worry. And if you hit the bottom, it's not deadly either.
I'm definitely taking falling damage.
Well, yeah, but you don't die.
Oh, okay.
All right. Notice how there's a little side area here.
Yes. Oh, it's so, so foggy here.
Oh. So this should be one of the other areas to unlock a character.
Okay. Ooh.
Yep. This one's a bit tough. We'll see if we can do it.
Yeah.
If we got the Knurls and we're on Drizzle, it shouldn't be so bad. But.
But
who knows?
It's me. I'm.
Yeah. Well,
I'll find a way to die. Ooh.
Okay, so we have a field. If you leave the field, you take damage.
Oh. Whoa.
It's not too much, and the Knurl should keep a lot of the damage off.
Okay.
But it's going to be a little painful. Benefit is we're on Drizzle, so it should be easier. So if you notice on the right, it'll say activate all cell vents, 9, and then breach how much and how many monsters there are. So currently there are only just a really basic mushroom monster, which is kind of lucky, because I don't know where they are, and they're kind of stupid and very slow, so they're just going to trundle around down below us.
Okay.
And,
oh, there they are.
Every time we breach one of these cell vents, we get an item, and then once we get all 9, we unlock a character.
Okay.
At least I think that's how it works. It's been a while.
Should we not shoot that mushroom, the mushroom boy? Oh.
Oh, yeah. No, shoot him.
Okay.
I just can't.
Oh, that's right. Oop.
Watch items on the ground. Nope.
Oop.
Well, you can just have the other one. I've gone places.
Okay, so now we need to move to find the next. Okay.
Yep.
I see. Oh, boy.
Yeah, so hopefully between the Knurls and the other stuff, we'll be in a decent spot.
Oh, boy. Yeah, the constant ticking HP is giving me some severe anxiety. Holy moly.
Oh. Okay, I found one of them, but it's not active. Look for a pillar of light, by the way.
Pillar of light.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm running towards it right now. Yeah, you got it. Like I said, I always play this with fans who know more than I do, so I just follow them.
There we go. Open the vault.
And then I just never internalize any useful information, which is bad.
Yeah, it's really easy to, especially when you cover so many games, and you cover even more, and I feel like I can't even keep like all the information straight, especially recently.
Yep. It's been bad. I've had to cut down heavily on, like, doom scrolling and reading news and stuff, because I realized it was making me 1,000 times more scatterbrained than I already am.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, I gotta cut this out, because this is bad.
Yeah, I've definitely looked at news a lot less recently. At first it was because, like, I was constantly in a situation where, I just didn't have the time to, and then I realized that during that time
this
I ended up being kind of happier, so I just kept it
up. Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so we just walk around doing these, all 9 of these, and we just are getting lucky?
Yeah, so
monsters are supposed to show up or something?
So we're currently lucky because we're being chased by a bunch of mushrooms that just suck. And that means we don't have to worry about them reaching most of our portals. Eventually, we're going to have another set of enemies show up, and then we're actually going to have to try.
Oh, okay. Oh, heck. Oh, there it is.
There it is.
This is a cool way to unlock a character, though.
Yeah.
I like it when games are creative with it, and it's not just beat the game with this character, and then beat it with the character you unlock, then beat it with the character you unlock from that, then beat it with the character you unlock from that. It's fun. It's fun to have, like, little mysteries and stuff.
Okay, so now we're having some more enemies spawn. So, the fair warning is that these enemies have boosted crit.
Okay.
Get touched by them.
The monster's items is what the monsters have? Okay.
Yep.
That's kind
of
neat.
Yeah, it's a neat way of handling it. They used to spawn sometimes with Tesla coils, which got real hairy real fast. Because they would just zap you to death.
Is the Tesla coil just like an AoE lightning attack or something?
Yep. Every single one of them. Let's see. Item we just picked up, by the way, is the sticky bomb. That is one of the best items, or at least it used to be, that would scale kind of endlessly. The more you get, the more damage it does. The higher proc chance and the bigger the boom. Ooh, glasses.
Get the high ground. Oh, there it is. So
yeah, up there
here.
It is. Huh. Pretty close too.
Yeah. It's neat. This is kind
of. Oh.
What?
They nerfed sticky bomb. That's a shame.
Oh, how dare they?
So good. Yeah. Ow! 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 Ooh. Oh wow, we got real lucky, item wise.
Is that item irrelevant for enemies?
As far as I can tell, it does nothing for them. Spare mag is amazing on certain characters. Spare mag gives you extra of your right click. I think you have like a bomb toss or something like that. For me,
yeah.
It's the spin. So getting a bunch of spare mags is amazing. With the what was the character that you started with?
Commando?
Yeah, Commando. I was just thinking guy that shoots good.
Guy that shoots good.
Yeah, exactly. So you get to fire, like, whatever your snipe shot is on that one. Just a bunch.
Hmm. I mean, that sounds fun. Whoop.
That's also good on the Huntress. It lets you throw your glaive a bunch.
Oh.
But yeah, completely useless on monsters. We're getting real lucky here. And we get stun grenades, I guess. Oh, that's convenient. Look at that.
My goodness.
Yeah.
It's like when the quest givers are like, I need you to go fetch this for me, and it's in the mailbox. And the quests, they're like, Okay, looks
my
like...
My personal favorite when it's like, I need you to go fetch this for me, and you already have it.
Yeah. And they're like, wow, you were quick.
That was fast.
But they say it even if it is a quest you... you know, you started on one day and then you turned the game off, you came back the next. Wow, you were fast.
I wish more games pulled like a Metal Gear Solid 3, where if you like went away for 2 weeks, one of the bosses would just die of old age.
Yeah.
That was magic.
Yeah, I adore that kind of weirdness.
I recently got into playing through the Fable series because my audience is just like, play Fable, and it's like, okay. Oh, well, we're here. The difficulty isn't scaling up. That's lovely.
That's great news. That is good news. But yeah, Fable.
But so one of the things I've been doing in Fable 2, because you get money based on, like, just real-time passing. Normally, like, when you're playing, it's every 5 minutes, but in-game, it's faster. Out of game, it's not so fast. But, you know, I'll come back, and, like, 24 hours later, I'll just have, like, 100,000 gold, and it's like, hey, this is kind of nice.
Yeah.
And so I've just been slowly buying out the town because I haven't been able to record anymore. So next time I go back, I'm just going to be the mayor of everywhere. And it'll be good. I normally hate it when games do that because then you have to, like, put it away for a while. Xenoblade Chronicles X was terrible because you had to have the game running 24/7 to have enough money to even buy into your equipment. It's like, this doesn't feel great.
Weird.
But
it's like
Fable,
it's mobile game stuff.
Super abusable. Yeah. And it can work in a small subset of games in a lot of them. It's just like, hey, this is bloat for bloat's sake.
Yeah, this is so that you think about coming back tomorrow and not never launching the game again.
Yep.
And, you know, it works.
I like it when games are like, hey, you're done. Bye.
Yeah.
See you in the sequel.
They're like, you played too much. It's been 30 minutes. You played too much. Go outside.
Yeah.
Go see if your neighbors want to play. Go ask if they want to shoot hoops.
I loved and hated that in Animal Crossing, where it's like, it was kind of nice to just be done, but I couldn't play consistently on a daily basis. So instead, what I did was I just was always like 10 days back in time on my Switch. And so every time I'd sit down to record, I'd just go through like a week's worth of content.
Yeah.
That almost worked. Yeah. But I think I like how Ooblet handled it, or Stardew, where it's just like, yep.
It's the day is small. Done. Day small, go to bed. Yeah, I like that too. Like, I don't know. I like that both exist. Because, I don't know, there's something fun about having a game where you log on, you have your tasks for the day, and then you do the next, you come back, you do it tomorrow. But usually only if it's like a relaxing game. Because then it's for like a relaxing routine.
Yeah, that's just too close to the, I am just not able to do anything. You're just ruining everybody.
Oh, it's good to, good to be good for once.
I think it's just too close to the mentality that I... Like, Animal Crossing is too close to my recording mentality. And so it's like, it actually gets too real for me.
Yeah.
Because, you know, every day, get up, you've got some tasks, record these games, and rinse, repeat. And so to do that in a very codified manner in a video game, suddenly just like, the curtain's been pulled back, I don't like it. Oh,
yeah.
I got that one. Or, you got that one, that.
I got one of them. I think you got the other.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's like, but it's even more, if you go in two layers deep, you'd be like, the game doesn't have like a failure state, but you know, you kind of make one. Like, if I didn't do all of my daily tasks, I failed for the day or something. And then it gets extra real, because then you can apply it to your real life. Oh, I didn't do my... I failed. I didn't didn't talk to my neighbor, catch a fish, and, you know, bought something. my favorite
okay
for animals...
not talking to my neighbors in real life.
Yeah, no. But my favorite one in Animal Crossing is when they're like, you get Nook Miles tickets for spending Nook Miles tickets.
Yep.
It's like, okay. Where's the...
I mean, that was easy.
Yeah.
But net loss?
Yeah, easy, but... Yeah, I think it's usually supposed to be a net gain, but it's still, like, net loss in, like, brain power. Because it's just like, I don't know.
Oh, they have ukuleles now. Even then, that's not that bad.
I wish they would, like... be on them too, the same way that they're on us.
Oh yeah, the syringes.
The ukuleles. Ooh, on their back. Oh, did I pick one up already? Did it land on me?
No.
Okay.
That one's yours. This one's a long ways away.
Oh no. Hearing your character run up there, and I'm just like moving at 2 miles an hour until I get to press shift.
That shift, though.
It's fast. It's a burst. It's a huge burst. Is this the last one, then?
Yes. I think so. And then we'll be done. And then we'll get an item. Cool. And the character. And the next... Akrid's pretty good. Has a lot of self-heals.
Okay. Is it a melee character or a non-melee character?
Somewhat.
Melee-ish.
You do like a lot of spits, but you have like a basic melee attack.
Okay. Hit me.
Yeah, we got really lucky on the RNG, because that item is Alien Head, which is completely useless on enemies.
Huh. This is kind of like a neat little... It almost feels like its own, like, mode. It's cool that this
mode?
Is... Yeah. Cool. It's kind of cool that it's just, like, this is how you get a character. It's just a fun little extra thing.
Yeah. It's effectively a secret level. It's not that secret, but...
Yeah.
You have to know about it to actually find it most of the time. All right, what do we get? Ooh. Shattering Justice.
Reduce the armor of enemies.
Reduce the armor of enemies after repeatedly striking them.
I do that.
That's pretty good on both of us.
Yeah. Oh, no. Okay, so the poison's gone. All right. Anxiety gone. Good.
Yep. And now you can actually see everything.
Yeah.
It's a lovely area.
It's pretty. It's snowy.
My character's just carrying it around in his offhand. I kind of wish it replaced his sword.
Yeah.
That'd
be nice.
This katana, I've just got like a dumb warhammer.
There's something great about my character holding it too. I don't know. Just like how he's just sliding around and doing it. I don't think I can make this. Nope. I tried.
It's okay. I can hit the teleporter.
Okay. Take me away. And we get to keep all those items too, and it wasn't scaling up the difficulty. That seems wild.
That was nice.
So you get to do that every time you find a blue portal? Or no?
You know, I actually have zero. I have no clue.
Okay. That'd be crazy if true. Kind of. It's very cool. It takes a decent amount of time though.
Okay. Once per run.
Once per run. Okay. That's, seems about right. Can't find any bad boys. They're all by you.
Let's see. I found a shrine that summons them.
Are there less enemies on easy mode, too? Like, just straight up less of them?
Sort of, yeah. So, part of the reason why it always seemed like the previous runs had so many enemies is because we were on a harder difficulty early.
Okay.
But if you notice, like, we're still on easy.
Yeah. It ticks up
so we're
slower, too? Or it doesn't
it
tick up
a little
slower,
while.
Okay.
Yeah, which some people have actually said, I think mostly with Risk of Rain 1, that once you get used to... Risk of Rain's, like, difficulty curve and, like, avoiding enemies, Monsoon's actually faster because you get more money sooner.
Oh, okay.
Let's see.
Delayed heal after taking damage.
It's nice. I think they might have buffed it. Let's see. This thing here...
Yeah,
I think is probably the best. It's just flat damage reduction.
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay, medkit is definitely buffed. Good to know.
Good.
Because, yeah, medkit used to just be kind of lame. Oh, hey, we can actually, seeing as we're playing on Drizzle, there's a door we can open up if we find two pressure plates.
Okay.
I don't remember what unlocks. I think it unlocks... I know it unlocks an item. Two items? I don't remember if it unlocks a character as well or anything. I don't think so. Okay, it just unlocks two items. That might not actually be super useful. Have they been buffed? Because last time I played this, they were always kind of trashed here.
Yes, absolutely. I know you're talking to me, of course. Being the resident Risk of Rain Master.
Sorry.
Being the resident
I
Risk
just
of...
have...
No, I know. I have all kinds of questions, and I... I don't know. If you don't know him, I'm lost. I don't have your chat open.
Let's see. Might hit the teleporter.
Okay.
We're going relatively fast, and we're depleting chests pretty quick.
I definitely feel like I've got a build that seems like it makes sense on this run.
That's kind of how Risk of Rain works. Like, it takes a couple of loops before you really fall into something that stands out. We'll do command mode after this. I'll have to host, but that should be fine.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. I was following the blue arrows. I thought that was for you. Oop.
Nope. Blue arrows are probably the healing drone and the gunner turret.
Yeah, I think so.
That we would just have sitting around.
I'm here. Oh my god.
Wow, that sprint does a lot of damage. Dang.
I got here right at the end. Enough to halfway through. Oh my god. The bosses are like normal enemies in the other difficulty. Or at least they were like later.
It gets there.
I mean, they literally summoned a magma worm.
Yep. You can have that item. It's one of the loot books.
Okay.
I don't actually know what the benefits are for stacking them all on one character. I think they linearly scale, so it's better that we, you know, have them across the board. My one fear with, the next run is I don't actually know if we're going to make another run after this, because this one's probably going to be a little easier.
Oh, we'll see. Let's see. Whoa. Because they're longer runs, aren't they? They're like a successful run is how long, you think, on average?
You know, I don't know. Part of it is because, like, up until now, looping was the only way.
Yeah.
Was the only way to actually, like, progress a run. And so now that there's, like, a definitive end, I've never timed it to the end because this is the first time I've seen it.
Well, then we'll find out together, probably. I mean, it seems like we're ripping through this one by comparison.
Oh, right. Find loot.
Meow.
I was real tempting. It's real tempting to just go to the 3D printer and just pick up a bunch of goat hooves instead. Just go real fast.
Just move real quick.
Boink.
I feel like without a mini map or something, I always have such poor, like, spatial recollection.
The one benefit is this game does not have really procedurally generated levels.
Mm-hmm. So they are, like, they're the same, like, literally the same layout every time?
Yeah, generally. There's a little bit of procedural generation. It's mainly the items. But this level will always look like this.
It'll
be laid out this way with the same items and so on and so forth. Gotta go fast.
We have roughly the same amount of items. Look at that.
Yeah. Alright. I guess let's go hit the teleporter. I don't know if you left many chests in your wake.
I didn't see any that I didn't open. Doesn't mean I got them all. Maybe I missed them.
Ooh. Is this worth it? This is. Well, shoot. Still worth it. This is becoming progressively less worth it.
What is this?
There was a 3D printer with infusions.
Mmm.
Which,
okay.
Worth it? Because getting max health is hard. They got rid of Bitterroot, or at least they didn't have it in the previous levels. Bitterroot used to increase your max HP by... I want to say it was like 8% every time you picked it up, and so just getting a bunch of infusions plus bitter roots together meant by the end of the game you'd have 9,999 HP. Mm. And that was good stuff.
I like that.
All right, I'm going to hit the teleporter.
Yeah, go for it.
All right.
Take me away.
But yeah, usually what they do with Risk of Rain is instead of having procedurally generated levels that like stand out from each other, they just have different alternate levels instead.
Yeah.
Which I'm kind of fine with.
Yeah. That, like, I don't know. You can get attached to the playing field the same way that every single match of a MOBA is on the same exact field. Doesn't mean every game's the same.
Yep.
In fact, they'd probably be, not as popular in a way, because they wouldn't get competitive as well, probably. So maybe it's, I don't know, maybe they're going for the same thing. They're trying to give you that competitive feeling with yourself. Who knows, maybe.
That's an interesting point. I'd never really thought about it. Did you play that one weird, like, ring-shaped map that everyone hated?
Dominion?
In League of Legends.
Yeah.
Was it Dominion?
I think so.
I thought that map mode was real cool, and like everyone hated it, and I was like, oh.
I thought it was neat. I didn't play it a ton, but like conceptually, I don't know. I thought it was a fun change of pace. I probably played it for a couple weeks, off and on. It was like a capture the flag built into the MOBA. And
oh, it was point capture. That's
yeah,
what it was.
Yeah. Or that. Sorry, that's what I meant to say. I didn't. Kind of like yeah, 100%. Like a Rothy Basin. To make it even, like, continue to make everything more niche is by the second. Not that World of Warcraft is a niche product, but I always try to.
Everybody's played it.
It's true. I always try to stop myself from referencing too many other things in a row because I'm like, like sometimes Rhapsody and I will get in a conversation. We'll start talking about like a show we watch, and then we'll segue into the like a podcast we both listen to, and then like. Completely forget to ground the conversation for people that have, you know, no idea what the hell this five-layer deep conversation is. Like, alienating more and more people with every single word we say. I try to not do it too much.
So
yeah,
they knew what they were signing up for.
You'd think.
You do not watch Stardew Valley for people talking about the game.
Or, yeah, at the very least, like, I don't know, what the hell do you talk about in episode 40, you know? You just,
yeah.
We need to complete our bundles. Great, the progress for the day has been done in the first 2 minutes. Let's sit and talk about what we did in the first 2 minutes.
The only thing that I remember being terribly relevant conversationally is when I played it multiplayer, three of the people were all trying to woo Elliot, I think it was.
Oh, yeah.
And so they were getting, like, fake jealous of each other and mad.
Okay. Yeah, I mean,
like
we haven't talked to our characters. We have, like, zero hearts with every character. We're antisocial.
Yeah, that's how I usually play. I usually just go fishing for a while. And
yeah.
Then at some point talk to somebody because they have something I need, and then I'm like, yeah, but
yeah.
Why?
Yeah. I never even got my character the, I joke as the ability to read, you know? Like, I never went to figure out how to read Junimo language or whatever. So I literally, my character, I can't even look at the bundles. I can't look at half the important progression stuff. So I have even less to do. So it's pretty much just a podcast thing.
You guys still going with that?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's like, it's very close to have run its course. We're the goal is literally to finish the bundles, and we're getting there.
Yep.
It's the kind of thing where we're in the home stretch where we, like, the last little bit is just taking a long time. But, yeah. Like, I don't know. We were talking about doing either Fall Guys or World of Warcraft after.
Wow.
Yeah, two completely very similar things. Classic World of Warcraft. If leg permits.
Is it that bad with him?
I don't know. We don't know. We'd have to try.
Fair enough.
It's basically like a toss-up, because like you would think Fall Guys would be terrible with U.S. to Australia ping. You'd think that'd be garbage, but apparently it's not that bad. It's at least palatable, apparently. But I don't know. I don't know with something like World of Warcraft, because like the gameplay of it is, you know, not that involved. I don't know how important it is, but it'd probably be annoying to play. Oops, I didn't mean to steal that.
I don't remember it being bad. I used to raid with a number of Australians. The worst part was just getting them to show up on time.
Yeah, I mean, for them it was probably, what, 4 a.m.?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, boy. God, I feel like night and day this run versus last run. Like the build feels better,
Drizzle
and it's so much easier too, obviously. But
Drizzle mode just makes a difference. I didn't want to say like let's just start on Drizzle. Generally just feels better to be on Drizzle mode instead.
I mean, just to start with, at the very least, like. But when a game says on the menu, this is the way the game's meant to be played, I can't not pick it. I just feel like what they said about the medium difficulty. Like, this is the way the game's meant to be played. So I'm like, all right, I'll start there and I'll work my way backwards. And then usually I usually never do.
Okay. I think I did the silly thing and came over here when there's nothing. I might be able to come back.
I could hit the teleporter. You want me to hit it?
Let's see. Give me 2 seconds. I think... Okay, I see some chests. I knew there was a spot I missed. So I actually didn't pick up much on this floor. Bustling fungus. Pointless on both of us. It's real great on the engineer. Real pointless on everybody else.
Yeah. Just... Here, I'll
stand still in this game. Are you crazy?
Yeah. Nope. Should I hit it?
Almost. There's more than we checked. Let's see. I think last two.
I'm getting max value out of my my fungus.
Dang, we apparently missed quite a lot, actually.
Sounds about right for me.
Yeah. All right, I think now you're safe to hit it.
Boink. Safe or not, there I go. So the experience does what? Like, does it increase your stats?
It increases your damage and increases your HP. I don't actually know if it increases anything else.
Okay.
Let's see. There is a secret something here that we can do.
Ooh.
And seeing as we're on Drizzle, it's not a bad idea. I think it's if we break a bunch of eggs, it pisses off a thing.
Sounds
and if
about
we
right.
kill said thing, I want to say it unlocks a character.
Okay.
It's either a character or an item around here.
I'm cool to do it. Make one big chunky run since it does not seem like we'll have time to do another anyway. Make one big chunker. I did not mean to. Oh, okay, good.
I got it. It's fine. I'm not going to be terribly mad if you just grab stuff. The only thing I would be mad about is if you took my neural.
I would never on purpose.
Steal another man's neural.
You don't steal another man's neural. Even I know that, and I don't know anything.
All right, so keep an eye out for what look to be egg clusters and break them.
Okay.
Which character is unlocked? I forget.
Greg? Space Greg.
Oh, hey, bustling fungus is actually kind of useful.
I got one egg cluster, I think. Are they really, really little?
Yeah, they're fairly small, yeah.
Then I think I got one. Keep on feeling serious. Is that the trade health post or trade health shrine?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was sacking health to just gain a bunch of money so I can start busting open big chests.
Big chest, big number.
Big chest, big number. Uh-oh. Okay, that's fine.
I hear screaming down there.
I did my, like, super slash on one of the bell guys. He died, but I kept slashing. It was a sight to behold. And I couldn't move for a bit, and I got worried.
You thought you found a new 1.0 bug.
Well, they said this game is perfect, and I'm here to prove that wrong.
They said it's perfect, the devs?
Yeah, in the patch notes, it said this game is perfect under the no known issues.
Wow. that's a bold statement. I kind of like it.
I like it. I like the pizzazz.
Yeah.
It wants me to find some real game-breaking bugs, but, you know, maybe we don't.
Are all, if you find one, they're intentional. If you find one, it's a feature at this point. Like, there's some bugs in games that truly just are great. Like in Enter the Gungeon, if you get fat bullets and you throw your empty gun, it gets really big. And it was a bug. And they did not remove it because everybody liked it. So now it's a feature.
Yeah. I feel like every game should be slightly unbalanced and slightly broken in fun ways.
Yeah. That's the thing. As long as it's a fun way.
Yeah. Celeste, I think, is probably one of the best. Ooh, Afterburner. Let's see. Celeste is probably one of the best examples. Sorry, brain found a new item. Of, like, game that is breakable in a very good manner. And features that, like, weren't originally in there. Like, corner boosting apparently wasn't a thing, and then the speedrunners found it as a glitch. Hmm. And then they're just like, yeah, we're codifying this as a game mechanic now. And everybody's happy.
Huh. I know about that. I've only played like a little bit of Celeste because it's one of the games where it's like I reserve every once in a while a couple games for ones that Grace and I will play, and then we'll just play like, I don't know, one session of it and then don't play it anymore.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, I wish I would go back to it, but we're on something else by next week. Because it's like, I don't know.
There's just too many games.
Too many games. Too many games. Moreover, too many good, like, good enough games. Like,
yeah.
Give me more stinkers so I can not have to make hard decisions.
Yeah,
so.
Do one episode on it and then be like, I'm done now.
Yeah.
This was fun for the time that I played it. I never wish to play it again.
Yeah. It was a perfect one afternoon game. That's just the other thing. I love games that are, like, not afraid to be 3 hours long and then be done.
Yeah. Carrion recently. Absolutely just a 3-hour game. Maybe 4 if you're trying to be completionist, and that's it. Alright. Well, I'm in space now. Cool.
Are you dead?
Good luck.
Wait, you're dead?
No.
Oh,
I'm in space.
Oh. Like, you literally got launched up?
Yeah. I did my spin move, and it just decided to fire me off into the sunset for reasons.
Huh.
I'm a dash machine. I love it.
Oh my god. My damage feels less impressive against this very large ball boy.
Yeah, ball boy is beefy.
Yeah, beefy, beefy. I'm also, like, not taking a lot of damage, though. I think if I just stand still, I may just heal back up to full. Yep. Huh. Yeah, I'm just, like, tanking through this for the most part. Until I won't, of course. But...
Oh, kill his little buddy balls. That's how you do damage to him. You're not actually supposed to hit ball boy. You're supposed to kill his friend balls.
Then I guess I'm doing a lot of damage because it was doing enough. Ooh, oh, I'm in space.
Yep.
Whap. Oh, boy.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Let's see. So, there's the red items. Sentient meat hook. Gross.
What?
So, there's another one near the teleporter.
Sentient meat hook. chance to hook all nearby enemies. Ooh. Get over here.
We should probably hit the teleporter at this point. We've been on this level for a while.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm getting dragged in by the casualness of everything.
Yeah, it's like it's slowly gonna just get really Oh wait, there's another boss? Wait, what?
That two bosses. One. Shrine of the Mountain.
No.
So there's two bosses here, but the other thing, the ball boy was just a completely
bonus boss. He gets real pissed off if you break the vultures.
Oh, that was
because
okay.
He's the friend of the vultures.
Okay. Ball boy loves eggs. Gotcha. See, I was expecting it to be some kind of like big harpy. But no, it's ball boy. Gotcha.
Yep. Ball boy loves eggs.
Ball boy loves eggs.
Hits it when you mess up eggs.
Don't mess up my eggs. Yes, it's night and day. I could literally just tank these hits. I could.
It's great.
It's really great. If I stand still, I'm just invincible.
I wonder if they made Drizzle difficulty too easy, but I think we all just also just got a really big boost with the Knurl.
Yeah, that and like the I think going to that extra zone, getting all those like items without increasing the difficulty at the same time seemed crazy. Like the fact that the difficulty didn't scale up while we were there, I think, was a massive deal. What's this?
Yep.
What the hell is this?
Chronobobble. Chronobobble. Those enemies on hit.
Yeah, I think it was fun to do the easy. I think I would rather, you know,
go back to
the normal. But it's like it's fun to see. I feel like I learned the systems better on this run, obviously, because I was playing it instead of watching it. But like,
this is true. It does actually get harder.
Yeah, I believe it 100%. Like, and I'm not even saying we'll win because you know I'll find a way. Life finds a way.
Okay. Thought I saw a satellite thing over here. That'll be good to go. Oh. Turn to leave. Whoop. Let's see. Anything up here? Nope. There it is. Oh. Egg.
Egg?
Broke egg.
Broke egg? Stop, okay. He's already sad.
Oh, that's what that is. Okay. I'm going to get the teleporter, I think.
Okay.
I think we got everything. There might be more. I don't know.
That's fine. Is it the meta to get every item, or is it the meta to get most items but still go quickly? Do you know?
Generally, you want to go faster. But not, like, too fast.
Faster, but not so fast that you don't get items.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Do you have the striped portion on your health bar or not?
Striped portion? Oh, yeah.
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 Apparently, that means as long as you can see those stripes, you're immune to being one-shot.
Oh.
That's actually quite nice.
That is really nice. One-shotting is just never a thing I like. Believe it or not.
Yeah. I find most games, if there's the possibility for you getting one-shot, it means the game has balance issues.
Yeah.
Or you're doing something real stupid.
Gunfire.
Yep. I don't know if you saw us chatting about it in general, but the RoboQuest, which absolutely kind of terrible name.
Terrible name, horrible
real
name.
Real good.
I watched a little bit of it. It looked kind of neat in that same vein as Gunfire. But yeah, that name, oh boy, for their sake, I do hope they rethink it.
Yeah, it's at least slightly better than Rogue Souls, but...
Rogue Souls, Dungeon Souls.
Barely.
Yeah.
Like, it works
Titan
for
Souls.
Rogue Souls and Dungeon Souls. Yeah, it worked for a couple of those.
Yeah.
Because they were the first. Like, Rogue Legacy, it was the first game to actually,
have roguelike.
Use just Rogue in the name since Rogue, kind of.
Yeah, yeah.
And now the indie apocalypse is just like, hey, by the way, this is roguelike, therefore we're going to call it Rogue. But it also has Souls-like elements. So we're going to call it Rogue Souls. And it's like,
Rogue Souls. Yeah.
You're right, but...
Send it back. Send it back. God, I love how this hook is just like trailing behind me when I do my dash. It's just, it's like floating. It's cute.
Ooh. This is a big boy. Ow.
There's a pigeon, a guillotine? Which one?
So, wax quail makes it so you jump farther. Guillotine makes it so you insta-kill enemies below a certain health threshold.
Yep. That sounds fun. I love that.
Wax quails are fun, but you only want, two of them.
What are they?
And then it's, just terrible. Actually objectively bad.
It's jump distance? What does that mean?
Yeah, so instead of going up, you go further forward.
Whoa.
Which can be quite useful for, getting around, especially if you're trying to avoid hits. But if you get, five of them, you can no longer control yourself, and you're just hurtling ever forward.
Yeah, that doesn't sound... jump height, I get it, I like it, give me more, thanks, I love it. Jump distance?
Oh, guillotine only works on elites. Yeah, but that's where you need them.
Yeah, that's fine. Are elites bosses, or are those the ones that have the things by their name, like the colors, like the fire and everything?
They're the ones that have the colors. They're the ones that are, on fire, or icy, or, a bunch of other stuff.
Okay.
It's usually pretty obvious which ones are elites once you get used to it.
Yeah.
More guillotine. And you've been clearing house. All it takes is for you to live through a level, and then suddenly there's no items for me to buy.
Oops.
It's fine.
I'm not used to seeing things. If I see things, I'm like, oh, Wander must have left it for me. This must be
fine. I'm doing great.
Yeah, you got. I mean, yeah, you still have more items than me, so I'll take a few more.
Oh, I love it when they stack up like this.
Bookworm.
There we go. That worked out great. Got a red item that gives me 3 of my dash instead of just 1.
Oh.
And my dash is very aggressive, unlike most. So I can just sprint for days, and I'm invincible while I do it.
Love me some iframes.
Oh.
I like just watching you. You're just zipping all over
the
place.
It's great.
It's really nice.
Oh, right. I think I remember how to get this character. Let's see. By the way, if you ever see a stone, monolith-looking thing with a swirly above it, that's a gambling shrine. You can activate them multiple times, but there's no guarantee you're actually going to get something useful out of it.
Ooh. My brain.
Useful is especially if you have a lot of money to spare and not a lot of chests left on the map.
Okay.
Which is especially useful now because there's not a whole lot of items on the map.
Yes. Not a lot of items. I see some. Hmm.
What's up?
Just seeing you continually offered the shrine and got nothing. Just over and over. Just hearing the sound. Wow. Wow.
Gives me free fireworks, though, which, I mean, that's kind of fun. We should probably find the boss teleporter.
It's over here. There's more items.
Yep. It's fair.
Whoop. I might catch up if I keep on taking all these.
I didn't even really think of it, but yeah, I do have a silly amount of items.
Boink. So wait, is this the level before the final one? Because it's got the different...
Yeah, different type. So we can either choose to loop, or we can choose to go to the final level. If we loop, we can unlock this character. Or if we beat the game, we can unlock the other character. I've heard from a lot of people the last boss is actually pretty hard, so...
Oh. I'm ready to
who knows?
Have my heart broken.
Sure.
Alright.
My biggest fear is that I heard from a lot of people the boss is kind of hard to reach.
Hard to reach. Okay.
Yeah. You have one Hapu feather, right?
Yeah. I got one, and then I also have a jump height increasing thing, so I'm actually not too bad for jumps.
Got that there was one that increases your jump height.
Yeah, and it's what's the interact key? Do you know? It just says
pick an item up?
It says jump higher and use the interact key to ground pound.
Oh. Press and hold E. And you will do a ground pound. There you go.
Neat.
The one caveat on that is it gets rid of your jump height for a little while. So I almost never do the jump. Ground pound, personally.
Yeah. That doesn't sound like something I care about using. I want to jump and dash and kill like you. I want to jump and use my dash attack.
I think it works.
I mean, I don't know why it wouldn't. It's just impossibly hard compared to yours, I bet.
Yeah.
All right.
Red, I should probably actually leave the lunar coins for you. I have to suppress my turbo. Gotta pick everything up.
There we are.
Hey.
Hey.
Just. Alright. So, I think we get a choice here.
Okay.
Nope. All right, whatever.
Nope.
Well, let's figure out what happens.
Maybe you loop after the final boss.
That'd be a weird change. Because usually what you're supposed to do is loop a bunch and then boss.
Yeah.
Oh, we already missed the choice. Ah, well.
Oh, weird.
Whatever.
Is it just like a different shrine? I mean, I'm fine with that. I'm totally fine with that.
Yeah.
Like, this is probably what I would have picked. For right now, to be honest, anyways. But.
Yeah. Okay, so it's apparently really easy to miss.
Oh, okay.
Looping now. Good to know. So the easiest way to loop now is with the password portal. What?
What? What?
They have changed things.
Are you bad? Okay.
It seems like a bad boy.
Yeah, I just wonder because that I entered the shop and that guy, the shopkeeper, had a health bar, and then I was shooting at him.
Oh, you can absolutely fight him. There is an unlock for it. I totally forget what the unlock is, but you can.
Yeah, so it's been so much better since I gained the ability to, I'm just gonna jump over this. Move faster.
Damn.
Yeah, I mean, I jump so high and floaty that getting in between the middle there is actually the hard thing. There we go.
My charge cooldown is so short, there's a very real possibility that as long as there's enemies for me to hit while up in the sky, I will never run out of charges.
Ooh.
What are you? This place also has really low gravity, from what I can tell.
Yeah, it seems so. Oh my god.
We...
Hello. So this is the final zone, though, or is this an...
Yeah, this seems okay. to be the final zone.
When does the rain start? Oh, it's happening. Okay.
Yeah, it's finally raining. It only took two games.
No longer any risk.
Yeah, it is real.
False advertising. Actual, just rain. Rain World. That's when the next game. And
have you played Rain World?
I have not. I've looked at it a bit.
Okay.
And I've heard wild things about it.
Rain World is one of the few. There are two games that have ever made me stop to have a snack break just to have the emotional fortitude to continue on.
Oh my. Huh. Yeah, I've heard things about it being like one of those kind of games that kind of mechanically does things that often you want to avoid, but it does it to make you kind of feel helpless.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's kind of what I've heard about it. And
yeah.
It makes me interested.
That's a good
in
way
it.
Of putting it. It's a very unique product.
I love unique products.
I've only seen like two other games, three other games do. Carrion is like the kind of easy expression of it, and then the other one is Mushroom 11, which is just hell.
Oh, boy. That one's familiar, too. I don't even remember with Mushroom 11.
It came out in, like, 2014, 2015. And that's the other game that required me to eat food to have the mental and emotional fortitude to finish. Except for I think I finished it and then I had like a victory burrito, which is slightly different, but like I
yeah.
needed it because I was just so
you
like,
needed
stressed
to,
out
to fill the tank, the brain tank.
So by the way, people are saying be very careful not to fall off here, as even with a couple of mobility you can get perma-stuck. Might not be a big deal for you.
Yeah, I'll try to avoid it.
I can fly, so it's not a huge issue.
Yeah. I can astronaut float fly. But I... definitely not quite flight. Not quite flight. You just, like, half the time I see you, you're moving at a million miles an hour in space, so...
It's great. Yeah. I knew people liked this character, but I never really put the time or the effort into learning why. Now I understand.
Many dash go fast.
Whee!
Oh. This is the big boss arena?
Seems like
it. Oh,
it
sure looks like it.
Seems about right.
Meow. Oh.
Huh.
King of nothing. Well, that's not so terrifying. If he's the king of nothing, you know. That's really... So am I, you know. I can say that about myself, too.
He's a quick boy.
He's punk.
Sartorius, but with low gravity. And a loincloth and a hammer.
King of nothing.
Where does it say that name?
It says it right underneath his health bar for me. MITHRIX, King of Nothing.
Oh, I don't have that.
Oh.
That's weird. It must be an option that I don't see.
Ooh. Oh, he actually does damage.
Absolutely got to be a second phase to this.
In theory. Like, this is such a big arena for such a small boy. Even if he's the King of Nothing,
small
he deserves something.
Zippy boy.
One small, zippy boy. You're nothing. Not only are you the king of it, you are it, my boy. You're nothing.
This is... Sorry. Ooh. Do not get hit by that, though.
Ow. I mean, he hits hard, but, like, not very often. I don't know. Maybe it's just because there's two of us, but it just...
Yeah.
I'm at full health by the time I get hit. Easy.
Me being next to him is a little dicey.
Oh, Me too. Oh, boom. my AoE was nothing compared to his. I tried to do the ground pound. It was like a two-foot radius.
His one's like the whole stage?
Yeah. Is he... Okay, there we go. The other things.
Well, he summoned some goons.
Yeah. I mean, this isn't the final stage either. This is just...
No.
This right here is like patented stage 2 material.
And not even. Like, yeah. In Risk of Rain 1, you fought the boss, and then you fought these, like, crazy worm things, and then you fought the boss again, but he was, like, super aggro.
Hmm. If he's not at least, like, 3 times bigger, I kind of want my money back. 3 times bigger.
That said, for, like, a game like this, the small boss is usually the deadlier.
It's very true, because you have to hit him. Yeah.
Like, in 100%. Dark Souls, big bosses, yeah, they're hard, but it's the small ones that you're scared of. Except for maybe Dark Eater Meteor. That one kind of breaks the convention. Tried playing Dark Souls 3 with my brother for the first time, because we never actually played it. He's never played it before, and so I was like, yeah, we'll do Dark Souls 3. That'll be fun, right? Got invaded like 7 times right from the get-go.
Oh,
okay,
boy.
Maybe not.
I have still not played Dark Souls 3. I have not touched it yet.
It's good.
Is
you
it?
Just have to, like... You just have to get used to the fact that you're never going to be playing alone, even if you want to.
Yeah. Often do. I mean, at least they don't have voice chat, right? You know?
Yeah, this is true.
That'd be something. King of nothing.
Okay.
He's definitely doing things now. I see those beams. I now feel like I can possibly be hit.
Oh, you can actually see him all the way up at the top of the skybox.
Yeah, that's what I was just looking then too. Did you see me Goomba stomp him?
Woo! Woo!
Oh, look at
I'm
that.
Dead.
Oh my god, he actually does things now. Oh my god.
Yeah, he two-shot me.
What the hell?
Good
He's
work.
Like really doing things. That's not fair. I got used to my lifestyle of not having to care about you. And now you decide to suddenly have an attack that two-shots my friend? Uncool. Now I'm gonna die. I mean, he does seem to have a very large issue hitting me in the air.
Yeah, he's very much a ground boy until he does that, like, star slam, at which
yeah.
point everything is just problems.
I was having some visual issues with them. Whoop. Huh. I wanted to Goomba stomp him again. Donk!
Uh-oh.
Okay, I feel like being on the ground is way better for this, actually.
For that.
Oh, God.
Ow. Ooh.
Yeah, it's way better to be on the ground for that part. God, only
yeah,
one...
you can actually avoid it.
Yeah. Just being the only boy here is...
It's risky.
It's a lot less damage coming out of me.
On the plus side, it is still raining.
It is still raining.
It's faint, but it's there. It's a drizzle. Oh, man, how cool would that be if the difficulty mode actually changed how much rain you had on the final level?
And that's it.
Yeah.
It just made it harder to look at. You just could see it less.
I would love that.
Yeah, that'd be great.
I played a game called Frog Detective, I think, recently.
Oh, I love
Frog Detective. No, it was a different one.
Oh. Frog Fractions?
I've never actually played Frog Fractions.
Both of those frog games are great. Ouch. Those are two very good frog games.
It might not have been. No, it wasn't Frog Detective. It was a different game. All I remember is it had like a billion difficulty modes and they all did the same thing except for one of them, which made the game like inverted.
Like,
and you had to just guess.
I love that. Oh,
you
boy.
Might have this.
I think I might. I mean, he only has one attack that I'm scared of.
And he has to hit you with it 3 times to kill you, so...
Yeah. It's taken forever, but, like... I'm doing it. Oh god, get down, get down, get down, get down. Oh, that was good right there.
Yeah.
I'm glad Papa was watching. I'm also glad you got to see my Goomba stomp. That one I'm proud of. Oh no! Not good. Not good. But
it's okay, he only does it a couple of times. Gives you plenty of time to recover.
Absolutely. Whoop. Poink. I just dashed into him and he died.
Nice. You got it.
Hello. Stop it. Oh, come on. No.
Was that all of your items?
He took my items.
Oh.
I'm getting some back. Wait, what the hell?
Yeah, so as you hurt him, you get your items back.
I'm getting damage over time, though. I don't know how to stop the damage over time that's happening to me. I can't move. What? What's happening?
Oh, he meat hooked you.
What?
He got you with a meat hook.
Oh, come on. Oh, Jesus.
What a turd.
What a dumb man. Are you kidding me? That's so annoying.
That's rough.
That is so annoying.
And he was bleeding you because of tri-tip dagger and a bunch of other things.
Oh my.
That's so mean.
I mean, oh god. Ew. All right. Fine.
Yeah. Probably wouldn't have been so bad if I didn't die on the second phase, but
yeah, well, I mean, I just like I don't know what any of the items do, so if he steals them from me, I don't know how to avoid them. Are you kidding me? I don't know what anything does. I don't know about meat hooks and everything. The only reason I was alive was my items.
He was also roasting us in the chat. Look at that.
Useless.